Hi, this is Catherine from AHA. Today I'm going to show you how to use AHA roadmaps to quickly visualize what you're going to build and when. We'll take a look at how to capture your goals, initiatives, releases, and features, connecting everything together to make it clear how you'll deliver against your product strategy. Once you've entered in all your data, you'll see how easy it is to quickly build a roadmap in seconds and share it with others to keep everyone aligned. Let's get started. Here we are in the strategy section in AHA Roadmaps. This is where you can set your goals and define initiatives. Let's take a look at goals first. As you can see, we've already defined our goals for the rest of the year. Now let's open one up and take a look. You'll want to give each of your goals a name, description, and a success metric that is both specific and measurable. Then we'll set a time frame. This makes it super clear what we want to accomplish and when. Once you have added your goals, the next step is to capture strategic initiatives or those big themes of work that will help you achieve them. Give each initiative a name and set the time frame for completion. Make sure you tie each initiative to one or more goals to show how it supports your overall strategy. Now that your strategy is set, it's time to plan exactly what you want to build and when. Schedule releases to plan when you will launch new customer experiences. For major releases, we recommend creating a Gantt chart. Let's add a new release. We'll give it a name, a target release date, and we'll use our default product template, which will give us key phases and milestones that are essential to a successful launch. Now we see our release appear on our Gantt chart, and when we expand it, we see those key phases and milestones. You can reschedule work right from the Gantt. For example, we want to move the start date of this release to happen right before the end of the release above. You can do the same for phases and milestones. Simply drag them across your timeline to reschedule the work. If you need more time, you can also adjust that range here. For example, development is going to take a bit longer, so we'll simply drag it across to extend that phase. These phases and milestones help us coordinate all of the cross-functional work that needs to happen to launch on time. Now let's head over to the features board to manage the details of what you want to build. Here, you can organize your product backlog and prioritize features into upcoming releases. In our example, we already have defined a few releases, and you can also see the new release we created a moment ago. Let's go ahead and add some features to it. There's a few ways that you can do this. You can add new features directly to each release, and if you're just setting up your AHA account, you can also easily import items from other systems. In our case, we're going to simply drag and drop features from the parking lot into this release. Now, let's open up one of the features and take a closer look at the details. As you can see, there's a lot of data that you can add, including the description, type, product value, and so on. But for the purposes of building our roadmap, the key fields to fill in are this date range. You can always adjust the start date and due date later as needed. And then you'll want to make sure that each feature links back to one of your product initiatives. This is essential for building your roadmap. Once you've added a few features, you'll have all the elements you need to build your first roadmap. As you can see, you can choose from a number of roadmap templates to quickly visualize your plans. This makes it easy to show the right level of information for different audiences. I'm going to show you the starter roadmap first, so you can see how easy it is to build a roadmap with all of the data that you've already entered. So let's select Use Existing and select all of our goals. Then we'll do the same for initiatives. To keep it simple, we're just going to work with that new release that we just created together. And then we'll add all of the features within it. In a matter of seconds, you can see how I built a visual roadmap. And from here, I can click into any of the elements to adjust the details or add new ones as needed. Let's now take a quick look at a couple of other roadmap examples. The strategy roadmap is a great way to show leadership and other stakeholders the timing of your strategic initiatives. And you can open up each one to see the supporting features. Or if you want to share more details, try the features roadmap. This one is perfect for showing exactly what is coming and when, with teams like marketing, sales, and support. In each of these examples, you can see how we're using the same underlying data and visualizing it in different ways to suit our needs. Each view has a bunch of different settings, and you can play around with it to make your roadmap look exactly the way that you want. When you're ready to share your roadmap with others, the first step is to save it. Then you can choose from a number of different options in the sharing menu. Add your roadmap to a whiteboard to collaborate with stakeholders, or create a presentation along with other aha views and slides to tell a complete roadmap story. Sharing as a webpage is also a popular option if you want to send out a quick link. And that's it. Now you can see how easy it is to build your first roadmap. Go ahead and give it a try in your AHA Roadmaps account today. If you need help, use the question mark in your account. Our customer success team is all former product managers and AHA experts. We're here to help you plan with confidence and deliver your best work. Thank you.